Chris with South Carolina Gun School, and today I want to talk about H.R. 5087, which is one of the other many bills that are trying to get passed through the government, pretty much kind of going after certain bans, essentially attacking the Second Amendment. And the only reason I wanted to bring this up is I had a CWP class this past Saturday, and one of the gentlemen was asking me about H.R. 5087, and I was honest with him. I told him, I said, I really haven't looked into that one yet. I've heard a few people mentioning it and talking about it, and from my understanding, they're calling it the assault weapons ban of 2018 or assault weapons of 2018 ban or something like that. And I went in after talking to him about it and kind of got to looking around, and I highly suggest everybody going in and taking a look at this bill. This is where it starts. The dismantle of the Second Amendment is honestly, this is where it starts. Now, do I think this thing is gonna get any ground or go anywhere? No, I don't think that at all. But the fact that they've even put it out there to me is a little disturbing. I understand what's happened in the past is horrible things that have been done. But those things are going to be done either way. And a lot of people don't really fully understand guns, and they just want to get rid of it. If they don't understand it, they want to get rid of it. So that's just one. There's a couple of others. I apologize, I don't remember these off the top of my head. There's a bunch that I've been looking at. You can go online, I think it's congress.gov, there you could just go to Google, type in H.R. 5087, and tons of stuff is going to come up. I suggest going to, I think it's congress.gov if I'm not mistaken, and you can actually look at the full bill there. And it's got a lot of guns people use every day, hunting, sporting, competitions. It's got quite a bit on there, but now there are some, they've also got a list of what's exempt from that. Most of it are bolt action, what are gonna do just as much damage. Most of your bolt action, you can get a little bit further away. Shotguns, what else was there? There was a lot that was exempt. I apologize, I don't have everything here in front of me. I just wanted to kind of put this out there so everybody can kind of be made aware, start making phone calls, folks. Call your congressman. Let them know how you feel about it. It's, like I said, I don't see it getting any ground. Now, once I first started looking into it, some of the things that I've been reading on what they're going to actually have to have done to even remotely get a vote on it is pretty crazy. So there's a petition that has to be signed. They got to have so many signatures before there can be any kind of big vote on it. So I don't see this getting ground anytime soon with where the Republican Party stands as having the majority. But now that could change. That could change if we're not getting out and voting. So that's one thing I've been guilty of in the past. So definitely make sure you're getting out and you're voting. Another thing, join the NRA. For all of you people that think the NRA is a terrorist organization, all I can say is just, it's not. It's nowhere close to that. They're there to try to educate guns and help protect the Second Amendment. So for people out there that want to do that and haven't done it, join the NRA. You don't have to become a lifetime member. There's plenty of ways you can join the NRA, and it's very inexpensive. So please go out and join the NRA. If you have local groups here in South Carolina, I think it's or South Carolina Carry Association or something like that. There's a National Association for Gun Rights. There's tons of groups out there, but now don't just go join in whatever group. Now, unfortunately, there are bad people out there that are going to use that to try to scam you. So do your research on the group that you're about to join. But we all know the NRA, we know that's not a scam. So if anything, definitely join the NRA. Groups like this are here to help us. So please go out and make sure you're doing that. like I said, voting. Make sure we're getting out and we're doing that. Because like I don't see this catching ground anytime soon. I don't see this really going anywhere. But what scares me is the fact that they've got it in there. Before that, it's just been going after the ammo. Some of the bills they've got now going after parts like the bump stocks, aftermarket triggers, and different things like that. So there's been other bills that have gone after parts, but now they're actually going after guns. They have a list, a huge list of guns that they're going after. So please go out, do your research, check this stuff out, stay up on this stuff. I try to do my best to stay up on it. But most importantly, like I said, make sure you're voting and join the NRA. If you are for the Second Amendment, join the NRA. And always remember, folks, if you're not shooting, you're reloading. If you're not reloading, you're fighting. If you're not fighting, you're dead. Train to live. See you on the range.